Welcome back. We are discussing two-way classification in BAPO 5. Today in this session, we discuss statistical analysis of the model. Statistical analysis of two-way classified data. This is one of the crucial part, very important part for which we have learned many number of points. Every term we have learned previously by taking care and to make the statistical relevant statistical analysis, we have learned all the parts. Now I give you some particular formula. Again, just recollect the formula and I move to the statistical analysis. So what are the some particular formulas? YSA is the yield, which we know. Yield is a measurement from the experimental unit by applying the ISO treatment and judge variety. Or simply we can consider YSA is a experimental unit. It is a measurement from the experimental unit. It is a measurement by applying the ISO treatment and judge variety. It is drawn from the judge variety and by applying the ISO treatment. That is also you can consider. And y bar I dot, the average yield, it is going to be average, it is going to be considered due to the ice treatment. The mean due to the ice treatment, simply you can consider. Mean due to the ice treatment, which is 1 by h, j is running, 1 by h summation, j is equal to 1 to h yij. And if you consider y bar dot j, it is average due to the jth variety. Average due to the jth variety. For according to jth variety, what is an average for all the observations? Dot I is running. 1 by k summation I is equal to 1 to k yij. And overall mean y bar dot dot is going to be considered y bar dot dot. It is 1 by k into h, or we can write n. 1 by k h multiplied by summation I is equal to 1 to k. Summation j is equal to 1 to h yij. And this is also can be written as it is 1 by k summation I is equal to 1 to k y bar I dot. It is also converted. Or it is also can be written as 1 by h summation j is equal to 1 to h y bar dot j. So these are the formulas for y bar I dot, y bar dot j and y bar dot dot. Y bar dot dot in terms of YJ, in terms of Y bar I dot, in terms of Y bar dot J. So which means you can write K into, for example, Y bar dot dot is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to K Y bar I dot. Similarly, H into Y bar dot dot is equal to summation J is equal to 1 to H Y bar dot J. So these are the certain formulas which we have to remember and recollect, and so that we have to move to the statistical analysis. What we do in the statistical analysis? In the statistical analysis, we minimize the error component. We consider some of the squares of the residuals. In which particular term you will get this? You can obtain from the error, that is error component. This is what the mathematical model YJ is equal to mu plus alpha I plus beta j plus epsilon ij. This is what the mathematical model from which this is our concentration epsilon ij. Epsilon ij is equal to yij minus mu minus alpha I minus beta j. Right? And we have to get the sum of the squares of the residual. This is called residual. This is residual deviation. Yij minus this. So I am saying deviation. So therefore, now we have to consider error component E is equal to sum of the squares of the residuals, which means in this fashion summation I is equal to 1 to k, j is equal to 1 to h, epsilon ij square. So which means it is nothing but it is summation I is equal to 1 to k, summation j is equal to 1 to h, yij minus mu minus alpha I minus beta j, the whole square. This is what the error component. So we have to differentiate, that is by using the principle of least squares, we have to minimize the error error. Okay, for which what we have to do is by the principle of least squares we have to and we have to estimate the parameters mu, alpha and beta z. By using the principle of least squares, by minimizing the error component, you have to find out or estimate the parameters mu, alpha I and beta z, three parameters respectively. So for which what we have to do is we apply the principle of least squares and we take and we partially differentiate it and we get it zero, you will get it. So that is the usual procedure. So now I am considering one by one I write this E is equal to E here. E is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to k summation j is equal to 1 to h yi z minus mu minus alpha I minus beta j the whole square, sum of the squares of the residuals, right? Now I do the differentiation by using the principle of least squares. By applying the principle of least squares, I get the estimates of mu, alpha and beta j. So for which I have to differentiate with respect to one by one the parameter. So dou e by dou mu is equal to 0 I consider, and so that I estimate the parameter mu, right? So therefore you consider this is a part of differentiation. So for example, this is f of x whole square. So doing f of x multiplied by differentiation of f of x, right? So therefore it is multiplying 2 into f of x first of all. Summation I is equal to 1 to k, summation j is equal to 1 to h, yij minus mu minus alpha I minus beta j. Again differentiation for yij minus mu minus alpha I minus beta j with respect to mu. With respect to mu is constant, this yij constant 0, minus mu differentiation is minus 1. And alpha, minus alpha I differentiation is 0, minus beta z differentiation is 0. So therefore this is minus 1 is equivalent to be 0. The equation we have considered, dou e by dou mu is equal to 0. So therefore this is 1. The 2 cannot be 0, minus 1 cannot be 0. Therefore this the term here, double summation, this particular term is 0. So I am taking double summation for all the terms inside. So which you will get the double summation I is equal to 1 to k, j is equal to 1 to h, y I j. That is the first value. Minus double summation mu. Double summation mu shall we write directly? We write one more step. Summation I is equal to 1 to k, summation j is equal to 1 to h mu. Minus this is double summation alpha I. Minus this is double summation beta j is equivalent to 0. I is equal to 1 to k, j is equal to 1 to h. Right? You see here now what is this? Double summation y is a, it is nothing but if you refer the formula y bar dot dot is equal to 1 by k h or n, we can have that summation double summation y is a. So y is double summation y is a is equal to, I am taking this, you consider n into y bar dot or k h into the y bar dot. So n into y bar dot I am writing, I am replacing. So it is n into y bar dot dot minus, you see here summation I is equal to 1 to k, j is equal to 1 to h, mu. Mu is a constant. Does not depend on both the summations. Summation I, summation j. So therefore here how many terms are there? K into h. Here h terms, here k terms, k into h. K into h is n. So n into mu. And you, now you see here summation, you see alpha I does not depend on summation j. You leave this for time being. Leave it. Or else h into alpha I, that is. Multiplied by summation I alpha I is equal to 1 to k alpha I. We have proved that two results. Summation I is equal to 1 to k alpha I is 0. Summation j is equal to 1 to h. Beta j is equal to 0. These are the two particular terms we have proved in the mathematical model, right? So therefore summation I alpha I is 0. Summation j beta z. You see here summation j beta z is 0. After that we have to do summation I. Of course it does not depend on summation I. So this term 0. And this is also, this term is also 0 since summation j is equal to 1 to h, we do that term. Because it is independent. First of all we apply summation I. So this is what I am writing, summation j first and summation I. Summation I first and summation j latter. And summation I alpha I. Summation I alpha I is 0. So therefore this term becomes 0. Right? So these two are the terms which is 0 because summation alpha I is 0, summation j beta j is 0. So therefore these two are the terms 0, so therefore z equivalent to 0, which implies Now I am cancelling them and taking this for third term right hand side. Therefore, mu is equal to y bar dot dot. But of course, the mu is not an exact form to write, and mu is going to be estimated. Therefore, mu prom is equal to y bar dot dot. So therefore, the estimated value of mu, the parameter mu is going to be estimated by y bar dot dot. You understand this? This is what the estimation of mu, right? So therefore, and one more. Now, by taking another equation, we have to estimate the parameters alpha and beta as well. So I am taking another particular equation with respect to differentiate with respect to alpha I and equate it to zero. So that is what this is what the separate differentiation I have explained in the one-way classification. That whenever you are differentiating with respect to I, in the summation, when we have the summations, then we must be take care about that only the ith part is going to be differentiated. Which means, for example, you explain, first of all, you have to expand this particular the term which consists of double summation. The ith term is going to be separated, which means you have to apply the summation, take the summation with respect to I first of all, which means this is the term I is equal to 1. Whatever the term here which consists of alpha 1, I am concentrating alpha I. Okay, alpha I. Because of the, we are differentiating alpha I. If there is any term with in terms of alpha I, the term consists of alpha I, the differentiation is going to be done. Otherwise, differentiation is 0. Right, so that is the reason why I am concentrating on that. So you see here I squared 1 by 1j minus mu minus alpha 1 minus beta j whole square. The term alpha is not there, so the definition is 0. That is the first term, plus second term which consists of alpha 2 and so on and so on. And this term y is a summation, I am writing summation j is equal to 1 to h y is a minus mu minus alpha I minus beta j the whole square plus and so on plus last term consists of alpha k term. Which means what is the meaning of this is alpha 1, which means summation j is equal to 1 to h y 1 j minus mu minus alpha 1 minus beta j the whole square. This is this term. Similarly, next summation, next and so on the summation. I is equal to 1, I is equal to 2, we put I is equal to 1, put I is equal to 2, and so on, put I is equal to I, and put I is equal to k. These are the terms you will get, this differentiation, if you are there, now you start the differentiation. Rho equal to alpha I is equal to 0. Then the differentiation for this is, for alpha I, for first term, here no alpha I, the differentiation becomes 0. Then I get all the terms are constant with respect to alpha I. Therefore, this definition is 0, and differentiation for the second term is 0, and so on. Ith term, the definition is, we have to differentiate, and so on, the differentiation becomes 0. Okay? Now, the differentiation is for ith term, that is this. Again, x square, or f of x whole square, the 2 into f of x, 2 into summation, j is equal to 1 to h, y is a minus mu minus alpha I minus beta j. Multiplied by the differentiation of y is a minus mu minus alpha minus beta j with respect to alpha I is this is y is a constant 0 minus mu constant 0, alpha I differentiation is minus 1 and minus beta j differentiation is 0. So therefore the we understand this is what the concept you have. That is the reason why there is no one particular summation. Don't think that there are two summations why you are not given. Why you are not written two summations here. So this is the concept behind it. Then we are differentiating I is equal to 1, I is equal to 2 and so on. After expanding all the terms, I is equal to 1, I is equal to 2, I is equal to I and so on, I is equal to k. That is the summation I was expanded and then differentiation is going to be done. Is going to be taken place. Right? So the differentiation is done after expansion of I, summation I. So therefore, summation j is equal to 1 to h here, only the summation here. And now you take the summations. So here summation j is equal to 1 to h, y is a minus summation j is equal to 1 to h mu, minus summation j is equal to 1 to h alpha I minus summation j is equal to 1 to h beta j is equivalent to 0, right? So which means summation j is equal to 1 to h by I say, which you recollect the formula of the j is running, that is y bar I dot. You will recollect the formula of y bar I dot. Y bar I dot is equal to 1 by h summation j is equal to 1 to h by I say. Yij, right? So therefore, it is h into y bar I dot. If you take this particular fraction and say h into y bar dot, y bar I dot. What is this? Summation j is equal to 1 to h yij. You see, refer here. Summation j is equal to 1 to h yij. This is summation j is equal to 1 to h yij. So therefore, it is h into y bar I dot minus. You see, mu is a constant. Does not depend on this summation j. So therefore, it is h into mu because h terms you have. J is equal to 1 to h. It's also alpha is also a constant, does not depend on summation j. Therefore, it is also h into alpha I. Summation j beta j is 0. Summation I alpha is 0, summation j beta j is 0. Therefore, this term is 0. So, answer is equal to 0. You cancel out h throughout the values. And then, what you have to calculate? Alpha I. So, y bar I dot minus mu minus alpha I is equal to 0, which implies alpha I is going to be estimated is equal to y bar I dot minus mu. What is this going to be estimated? You see, clear path of estimation is visible here. Without estimating mu, we cannot estimate alpha I. We cannot get the value of alpha I. So therefore, you have to estimate properly now. So which means, which implies I estimate alpha I cron is equal to y bar I dot. Why the I this is a value getting from the data. This is a value can be obtained from the data. Therefore, no need to estimate this value. Y bar I dot cron is not there because it is a value obtained from the data. So therefore, no need to estimate. And this is going to be estimated. Mu, it's a parameter. It is not a parameter, it is a statistic. It is a parameter. We have to estimate this. So it is equal to y bar I dot minus, this was estimated previously. The value is mu y bar dot dot. So therefore y bar dot dot. So what is the value of alpha I? Estimation of alpha I. Alpha I cron is equal to y bar I dot minus y bar dot dot. You observe this. This is which kind of variation? This is the between the variation, between the classes, which means here between the treatments, y bar I dot, I is equal to 1, y bar 1 dot minus y bar dot dot. The variation of the treatments, it is going to be compared with the list, the mean. The mean is mean of the either treatment is going to be compared with the overall mean. Mean of the first treatment, mean of the second treatment, and mean of the K treatment, which are compared with the overall mean, which is nothing but observing the variation between the treatments. Between the treatments. So that is nothing but the variation which can be identified. Identified due to the treatments. So such the variation is known as due to the treatments. The variation due to the, is observed, which is nothing but it is because of the due to the treatments it is observed. It is obtained. Like so, therefore, this is one particular part. In the second part, I'll explain. In the next part, in the next class, next lesson, I explain beta j, how the beta j estimated, and how the remaining part of the statistical analysis. In the next part of the statistical analysis, I explain remaining. I hope in this particular part, we have considered the formulas, and we have considered the other component, which is the sum of the squares of the residuals. And by using principle of least squares, we have estimated two parameters, mu and alpha I. And in the next class, we learn how to estimate parameter beta j and remaining analysis. Thank you.